said then we'd like to look at the timelines that we are looking at. And remember, if this had not happened, if NASA was not going to the Supreme Court, then with those that are going to be tasked with a huge, humongous task of making that decision. It rests on seven judges, starting with the Chief Justice, David Maraga, and the Deputy Chief Justice, Philomena Mwilu, who, of course, are going to be in that seven-judge bench. There's also Isaac Lenaola. You have J.B. Ojuang. You have Ibrahim Mohammed. And we also have a few more judges who basically this rests on. And you have Njoki Ndongo, Justice Njoki Ndongo, and Smoking Wanjala. So basically, that is the seven-judge bench that is going to be tasked with the decision of going through all the evidence that NASA has today, which is, I believe, today, August or Friday. Because that's a deadline. The deadline is on Friday. The deadline is tomorrow for them to file any petition against the results that were given. So we expect that they're going to do that either today or tomorrow being the latest. Then to serve Jubilee and IEBC by Sunday, the 20th of August, because they must serve Jubilee and IEBC with that particular court order saying that they are going to contest and reject those results. Moving on now. NASA, Jubilee and IEBC to respond by Thursday, the 24th of August, to that particular court order. Then a pre-trial conference by the 25th of August. These are timelines that must conference, and by 1st of September, there has to be a ruling. So based on the ruling that the court is going to give, that, of course, tells us the direction. Should they rule that